In terms of our time, ladies and gentlemen, Christians don't teach or believe that the Bible is perfect. That is a Quranic claim about the Quran. So you have to judge the Quran by what the Quran says, and the Bible by what the Bible says. So the Bible says it is here to teach you about who God is and how to live. It doesn't claim to be perfect like the Quran. So when the Quran, stop interrupting. So when the Quran describes the earth like a bed, put your hand up if you think a bed is a round ball. Go on, put your hand up. Oh, nobody, not one of them, not even hijab. But the Quran describes the earth like a bed. Surah 43:10. It says, "Who made for you the earth like a bed."
Let me tell you something, this thing about bed, he keeps saying bed. The word mihada means cradle. So for example, when Mary alayhi salam, Maryam, when she was talking about Jesus, how she mentioned that term, that the mehd, when he was in the mehd, the sabiya, which means what? Cradle. That's point number one. Point number two, the shape was not what is intended here. That what was intended in Alam Naj'al al-Ardha Mihada was the comfort. But you don't understand imagery. The point of the matter is this. He says he doesn't believe in biblical inerrancy. By the way, a large portion of the Christian community, probably all of those in this park, believe in biblical inerrancy, which is the idea that the Bible is flawless. He is heretic in his belief, according to those. No, he is. According to evangelicals who believe in biblical inerrancy, he would be seen as a heretic. He knows that. Now, moreover, here's the point. When you first open the Bible, and I say this again, the first thing you see in the Bible is contradiction. How do we know that? Because vegetation is mentioned as happening on the fourth day in Genesis chapter 1. But when you look at Genesis chapter number 2, verse number 6, it said that no plant has sprung up yet. So much so that even scholars are saying this is a contradiction. How could you have the vegetation on the fourth day in Genesis 1, and then in Genesis 2, 6, it says no plant has sprung up yet. So whether the plant's there or whether the plant's not there? That's the question. What day and night there? How can you have day and night without the sun? You're talking nonsense. How dare you come with this to us? How dare you, our clowns? You're coming to us and talking about science. You've got your 6,000-year-old universe, which he didn't even mention. He didn't even refute it. He can't defend himself.